What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network, here with a reading of the Bitcoin Optech Group newsletter. Thank you very much to all the contributors and sponsors of this fantastic open source research group. Today, newsletter number 30, on January 22nd, 2019. This week's newsletter describes a proposed Lightning Network feature to allow making spontaneous payments, and provides our longest ever list of notable code changes to popular Bitcoin infrastructure projects. News: a pull request opened for spontaneous Lightning Network payments. Lightning Network protocol developer Rosebeef opened a pull request to allow any Lightning node to send a payment to another node without first receiving an invoice. This takes advantage of Lightning Network's Tor-like onion routing by allowing a spender to choose a pre-image, encrypt it so that only the receiver's node can decrypt it, and then route a payment along Lightning Network like normal using the hash of this pre-image. When the payment reaches the receiver, they decrypt the pre-image and disclose it to the routing node in order to claim the payment. Spontaneous payments help in cases where users just want to do ad hoc payment tracking. For example, you initiate a 10 millibitcoin withdrawal from an exchange, and either 10 millibitcoin show up in your balance within a few moments, or you contact support. Or you publish your node's information, and users can send you donations without having to get an invoice first. For tracking specific payments, users should still continue to generate invoices which can be uniquely associated with particular orders or other expected payments. Rosebeef's pull request for LND is still marked as a work in progress as of this writing, so we don't know yet when the feature will become generally available for LND users or whether other LND implementations will also provide the same feature in a compatible way. Optech recommends, if you prefer listening to audio rather than reading the weekly Optech newsletter, Max Hillebrand of the World Crypto Network has recorded readings of every newsletter to date, providing a total of more than 6 hours of technical news about Bitcoin so far. Audio and video is available on YouTube, and audio only is available as a podcast via iTunes and Acast. Optech thanks Max for volunteering to perform the readings and for doing them so well. We encourage everyone who prefers to receive the newsletter in video or audio form to follow Max for future readings. Well, Optech, thank you very much for allowing me here to do these recordings. Well, I didn't ask much for permission, but nevertheless, thank you very much for the great collaboration. And I'm looking forward to continuing doing these readings in 2019 as long as you provide this amazing information. Thank you very much, and let's continue. Notable code changes this week in Bitcoin Core, LND, C-Lightning, Eclair, and LipsecP256K1. A Bitcoin Core change makes the unload wallet RPC synchronous. It will not return now until the specified wallet has finished being unloaded. And this Bitcoin Core change adds a new GetRPCInfo RPC that provides information about the RPC interface. Right now, it returns an active commands array listing all RPCs that haven't returned yet. This LND change adds a standalone watchtower, allowing it to negotiate sessions with clients, accept state updates for active sessions, monitor the chain for breaches matching known breach hints, and for publishing constructed justice transactions on behalf of Tower clients. This is one of the last pieces of the initial Watchtower implementation that can help protect Lightning nodes that are offline from having their funds stolen, a feature that's an important part of making Lightning Network mature enough for general use. This Lightning Network change adds the default policy for the Watchtower, such as allowing the tower to handle a maximum of 1,024 updates from a client in a single session, and allowing the watchtower to receive a reward of up to 1% of the channel's capacity if the tower ends up defending the channel, and setting the default on-chain fee rate for justice transaction that is breach remedy transactions. And this LND change gives the Sendcoins RPC a new sweep all parameter that will spend all of the wallet's Bitcoin to the specified address without the user having to manually specify the amount. And we have a couple C Lightning changes here. The first, which extends the list peers commit with a new funding allocation MZUT field that returns the amount initially placed into the channel by each peer. This C Lightning change extends the list channels RPC to take a source parameter for filtering by a node ID. The same pull request also causes the invoice RPC to include routing hints for private channels. If you have no public channel, unless you also set the new expose private channels parameter to false. Route hints suggest part of a routing path to the spender so that they can send payments through nodes they previously did not know about. The C-Lightning change enables plugins by default on C-Lightning again, but a node is added to the documentation indicating that the API is still under active development. This C-Lightning change adds a lib plugin library that provides a C language API for plugins. And this gives plugins the ability to register hooks for certain events that can change how the main process handles those events. An example given in the code is a plugin that prevents the Lightning Network node from committing to a payment until a backup of important information about the payment has been completed. And we have this Eclair update, which adds limited probing. Probing in Lightning is sending an invalid payment to a node and waiting for it to return an error. If the node does not return an error, it is likely means that it or some other node along the payment path to it is offline or unable to process payments. Because the probe was an invalid payment that can never be redeemed, the sending node can immediately treat it as a timed out payment with no risk of loss. This update to Eclair only allows probing of nodes' direct peers, the nodes with which Eclair has an open channel. Peers, you really should subscribe to the Bitcoin Optech Group newsletter and thank very much the amazing contributors to this open source group. Thank you very much and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.